My name is Daniel Wynn. I'm a fifth-year graduate student in Dr. Sylvia Daunert's lab at the University of Miami Miller School of Medicine in the Department of Biochemistry and Molecular Biology. And the reason I'm here is to try to develop biotechnology. Essentially, what we're doing is we make strains of bacteria that if you put them on a piece of paper and you introduce them to these chemicals we're trying to detect, the paper turns blue. That's it. So there's a lot of complicated mechanisms behind that, but the end result is a piece of paper that if you put it into contact with a chemical we're trying to detect, will just turn blue. But you definitely have a lot of opportunities to do problem solving. So anybody who likes puzzles or anything like that will understand. We are constantly facing new problems. We're constantly developing new solutions. And working in a lab like this, we're really have a broad scope. I was born in Hilton Head Island, South Carolina. So like a small, relatively small town off the coast of South Carolina. In high school, I was pretty much just interested in playing sports and having fun. I really didn't have any aspirations kind of beyond the short term. I didn't really start to make any decisions on, you know, what I really wanted to be or what I wanted to do probably until midway through college. You know, I always imagined I'd be rich and famous by the time I was 26, but unfortunately, it didn't work out like that. In the later years of college, you know, I worked in a lab for some course credit, and I found I liked it, and then the economy crashed in 2008 right before I was about to graduate, so I decided graduate school was a good idea, and, you know, here we are. But it's an interesting profession, and I have always enjoyed the research. And what I'm doing is I have that immobilized, that strain immobilized on some paper strips. I hope that we can actually produce some technology that is actually viable for use, whether it be for research purposes or in actual commercial applications, so things that people could use outside of a lab and actually use in their homes, since a lot of the chemicals that we are actually trying to detect are virtually everywhere. And hopefully something good comes out of our research, whether it's someone takes an idea we had and takes it in a new direction, which is kind of what we do anyways. So hopefully, in the end, regardless of whether or not our projects actually become a huge commercial success, hopefully we'll have contributed to, you know, the human race, I suppose, and science in general. If you really want to do it, just start sending emails. Start getting in contact with people. Just do it. If science is something you're really interested in, I would say try actually doing it and just get in contact with scientists and get in contact with the labs in your area, and they'll let you work for free.